Welcome back, Sebastian here. So in today's video, I wanted to just have a little talk about red flags in Formula One recently. So after the Australian Grand Prix last weekend, we had a record-breaking 3 red flags in the race, plus 1 after the race, which doesn't really count. But I think it really got me thinking about the last couple of years. We've had way more red flags than I think in the previous like 7 to 8 years or so. So today I just went on Wikipedia and had a look at all of the red flags that we've had since 2010, and I just kind of broke them down into why we had the red flag and see if we can see any recent trends that may reflect this overall increase in red flags in the last 2 to 3 years. So starting off in 2010, we had 19 races that year and 1 red flag, which was in the Korean Grand Prix caused by rain. 2011, we had 19 races that year, 2 red flags, Canada and Monaco. Canada for rain in the very famous 2011 Canadian Grand Prix, as well as 1 crash related in the Monaco Grand Prix that year. 2012, 20 races that season, 1 red flag for rain in Malaysia. 2013, 19 races and 1 red flag, which was for a crash at the Monaco Grand Prix. 2014, highest number so far, 19 races and 3 red flags. 2 red flags in Japan and 1 at the British Grand Prix. So 1 for rain and 2 for crashes. 2015, no red flags. So 19 races, no red flags. 2016, in 21 races that year, we have 4 red flags. 2 at the Brazilian Grand Prix, 1 at the Belgian Grand Prix, and 1 at the Australian Grand Prix. 2 of those were caused by rain, and 3 because of crash. You'll notice that adds up to more than 4, but 1 of the red flags at the Brazilian Grand Prix is officially listed as rain and crash of Kimi Raikkonen. So I just decided to include it as both. 2017, 20 races that year, 1 red flag, which is at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And then 2018, 2019, both 21 races, 0 red flags. And this is where things start to change. 2020, 17 races, so the fewest races of any season that I've looked at, and 4 red flags. Bahrain Grand Prix, Italian Grand Prix, and 2 at the Tuscan Grand Prix. 0 for rain and 4 because of crashes. 2021, 22 races and 7 red flags, the highest of any year that I've looked at by an extremely wide margin. So let's go through all of them. So we have, first we had 1 at the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix, we had 1 at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, we had 1 at the British Grand Prix, Hungarian Grand Prix, Belgian Grand Prix, and 2 at the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So a lot of red flags that year. 2022, 22 races and 3 red flags. Red flags at Monaco, Japan, and the British Grand Prix. And 2023 through 3 races so far, we have also have 3 red flags. All 3, of course, coming at last weekend's Australian Grand Prix. And those 3 were all because of crashes. Oh yeah, so going back, so 2020, all 4 were crash. 2021, 1 was because of the rain and 6 were because of crashes. 2022, 1 was because of rain and 3 were because of crashes. So now I want to break up the red flags that were caused by crash. You know, rain is rain and, you know, it's very unpredictable. And that's a separate discussion because I know there was quite a few incidents last year with races basically not starting because of rain, which may have raised this number quite a bit. But I just want to look at the ones that were caused because of crashes, okay? And I basically split them into 2 categories. 1 is barrier and 1 is debris / gravel / crash. Now, in dry conditions, which generally speaking, one of the reasons that we have a red flag is that the track marshals, the people running the race, the race director, want to look at the barriers or replace the barriers if they think the barriers have been broken or damaged. And generally, as F1 fans, we kind of accept this as, you know, a necessity, right? If you have a damaged barrier, you don't want another driver crashing into the same barrier that's damaged and not getting the same amount of protection, safety protection, that they should get when they crash into that barrier. Debris is a bit more vague, because obviously what determines how much debris is necessary for a red flag to be called, right? Anytime that there's a crash, or even like a puncture, you can have debris on the track. But it's quite subjective to say how much debris is red flag amount of debris and how much is just a safety car. Other things where it's just a crash, obviously we've had some very massive crashes over the years that have just resulted in red flags. For example, Romain Grosjean's crash at the Bahrain Grand Prix was an immediate red flag. And what else? Let's see, Fernando Alonso's crash at the 2016 Australian Grand Prix was another red flag. So, of course, some of these red flags, it's hard to tell, like, quantify exactly why, how much of a crash is necessary to cause a red flag. Of course, you often also have tragic incidents like Jules Bianchi's fatal crash, where it was immediately red flagged for good reason, I think. So I've now split the two up, and we're going to go through them year by year. So 2010, of course, no crash-related red flags. 2011, one because of debris, crash, or gravel, which I've labeled as other. 2012, no crash-related red flags. 2013, one barrier-related crash at the Monaco Grand Prix. So this is the one where basically Maldonado and Chilton basically crash into the barrier going into It's basically the very fast left-hander, I think, and it basically took the Tech Pro barrier off the wall, and it was basically on the racing line, so that had to be a red flag. 2014, one debris, gravel, other related, one barrier related. 2015, no red flags. 2016, two other related, and one barrier related. 2017, one debris related crash. Then 2018, 2019, no red flags. And 2020, we had two for debris or crashes, and then three for barriers. Romain Grosjean's crash was classified as because of a crash, but he went through the barrier, and that barrier had to get replaced anyway. So I put that also under barrier. 2021, we had four red flags for debris or crashes, and one for barrier. In 2023, we've had three crashes, three red flags, all for debris, gravel, or crash. So the interesting thing I want to note is that the first red flag, Alex Albon's crash, was officially because of gravel on track. And this is the first time I can ever recall, and I checked on the Wikipedia, the first time that we've ever had a red flag because of gravel on track. Usually when there's gravel on track, because a car has basically gone through a gravel trap and they may have come back on track, or they may have pushed someone to the track, as what happened here. Usually the marshals will just kind of sweep it up with their brooms and it'll be fine. But for whatever reason, they decided to throw the red flag here. And the first race that came to mind that was a slightly similar situation was the 2019 Spanish Grand Prix. At that race, if you don't recall, basically Lance Stroll and Lando Norris had a crash. They went into the gravel trap basically at the exit of turn two, and Stroll was basically beached, but then Norris was able to keep going, had a lot of gravel on his car, and basically dragged it all across the racing line when he basically cut across to try to continue, but then retired. And I remember during the safety car, you know, there's quite a few minutes where the marshals were just kind of sweeping gravel for a while. And I really don't think the risk of punctures is that bad with gravel, especially at slow speed, maybe at high speed, but you know, at safety car speeds, the risk of gravel shouldn't be too much of a problem. So that's really the one red flag out of the three that I think should not have been a red flag. And even the commentator has said as much as well. The second red flag, the Magnussen crash, I think the FIA remembered basically Abu Dhabi in 2021 and the Italian Grand Prix last year, where the race ended under a safety car. And I think their trigger reaction was they didn't want a repeat of that, even though basically what we know now is that basically part of the wheel rim from Magnussen's wheel, which is like very sharp and dangerous metal, magnesium, was basically on the track, which would have caused very serious punctures. And, you know, maybe that justifies the red flag in itself, but it really felt like they saw that there was 2 to 3 laps left, and they're like, we have to call a red flag now, just to make sure we finish under a green flag, which led to the chaos on the third red flag, which I think is probably the only justified red flag, given how many cars there were that were parked in quite dangerous places. 4 cars retired, debris everywhere from the Gasly Ocon crash as well. So those are the red flags, and you can see, like, even from the debris gravel crash chart, we have more crashes. So we've had 2 every year since 2020 for debris gravel crash, and there's only 1 year in the previous 10 years where we have more than one red flag for one of those reasons. Just to show that I think with the recent change in race direction, you know, we had Charlie Whiting for so long of that time period, except the only time, except for 2019 and 2020, and 2021, which were all Michael Massey. And then last year we had Niels Wittich and Eduardo Freitas. And this year I think it's just Freitas, or is it just Wittich? It's only one of them. So I think it'll be interesting to see how the rest of this year continues and if this trend of more red flags continues, because unfortunately it's something that the teams will have to start considering with strategies. Is this kind of crash a red flag? Is this kind of crash a safety car as well? So there's my discussion for the red flag situation so far this season. Please like the video if you enjoyed. Please leave your thoughts as well. Did you think that the red flags that we saw in the Australian Grand Prix were too excessive? Do you think it was about right? And please subscribe if you enjoyed and you want to see more. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.